President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Friday signed into law a measure that is seen to unburden farmers from long-standing agrarian loans. The new Agrarian Emancipation Act, which was among the president's promises during his first SONA, condones over 57.5 billion pesos of unpaid debts owed to Land Bank of the Philippines by more than 600,000 farmer beneficiaries for the amortization of lands awarded to them under the Agrarian Reform Program, including penalties, interests, and surcharges. Under the law, beneficiaries are still required to pay for their lands for a maximum period of 30 years, with a 6% interest before finally being able to own it. However, many of these farmers are still unable to pay their debts.
We have been talking about this for a decade, and that everyone seemed to agree that it was time for us to look very closely on the financial situation, not of the banks, not of the financing institutions, but of our farmers. And so it has been the general consensus that it is there is no reason for us to continue to chase the unpaid loans, the unpaid benefits that have ballooned over the many, many years. And so to wipe the slate clean.
After the signing, President Marcos led the distribution of 32,000 land titles to over 27,000 farmers who are now able to own their lands.
Lahat naman kasi ng tao may mga pangarap na magkaroon sariling lupa na mapagtatayo ng mga bahay at mapagkakakitaan. So malaking bagay po ito sa amin.
Marcos, however, says agrarian reform should not end by simply distributing land to farmers.
Free land distribution must go hand in hand with broadening the provision of credit facilities and support services in the form of farm inputs, equipment, and facilities to our farmers, as well as the construction of more farm-to-market roads. These efforts will yield more sustainable farms and higher incomes for our farmers.
The president says at least 1 million hectares of unused lands are now expected to be used as additional rice lands, which is a big boost to the country's food security. The Department of Agrarian Reform, meanwhile, assures that these lands will not be easily sold by the beneficiaries.
Unti-unti na namin na pinapayuhan ang ating mga agrarian reform beneficiaries na naayon sa batas. Meron hong kailangan pag naibabot sa kanila ang kanilang titulo, kailangan maghintay sila ng 10 taon bago nila maibenta ang lupa sa iba. Sapagkat pag nalaman po ng agrarian reform na kanilang ibinenta ang lupa nila na hindi pa lumalampas ang 10 taon, eh babawiin po ng pamahalaan at ibibigay natin sa ibang beneficiary ang lupa po.
Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno says that the over 57.5 billion pesos of condoned loans will not affect the government's revenue.
Wala pong impacto sa fiscal picture ng gobyerno dahil naplano na po namin over the next 5 years kung ano yung deficit target natin, anong revenue. Hindi po kasama ito sa computation. And it will benefit, as mentioned by the President, many agrarian reform beneficiaries. Pag nagtapatakbo pa kayo ng gobyerno, hindi lang po efficiency yung inyong iniisip, social justice din po kasama dyan. So this will fall under social justice.
Marcos Jr. meanwhile directed the Agrarian Reform Department to hasten the resolution of pending agrarian cases in the country. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.